and Dr. Mohan Chennai, son of Adyar Gopal Krishna Chennai and Srimati Radha.
Just before the palace entrance, there is this famous temple of Udaipur. This is known as the Jagdish Temple. There are 32 steps here. As you can see, it is a magnificent temple. The deity is Lord Vishnu. This temple was built in 1615 by Maharana Jagat Singh I. The sculpture is outstanding. There is free food served here for the poor every day.
Hey, Margire, bichu kha gyo re, ali ja panat kar pine. Bichu kha gyo re, ali ja panat kar.
There is a Hanuman Murti here. After visiting this temple, we proceeded to the palace. Now we have arrived at the city palace, which is close to the Pichola Lake. The palace is converted into the government museum. The entire area that is painted yellow is area of the palace. The entrance ticket for the palace is 50 rupees per person. And 200 rupees for each camera, video or still. As we had a still camera and a video camera, we paid 400 rupees plus 100 rupees entrance fee for two, in all 500 rupees. These are the gates of the palace through which the visitors enter. This is the Bada Pole. This gate is also called the Bada Gate. These arch-like structures are called torans, and they are associated with the practice of the Maharana getting weighed against gold or silver, and the equivalent value is distributed to the poor who lined up at the gate, sometimes up to the other end of the city. This is called Tulabharam, and the spot where it occurred is at the Tripolia Gate. The palace here is the largest palace complex of Rajasthan. There are 11 palaces put into one here. Although Chittorgarh was the capital of Mewar before it was sacked by Akbar, Rana Uday Singh I gave it up and continued Udaipur as the capital. Chittorgarh never regained the honor of being Mewar's capital. Maharana Pratap Singh I wanted to come back to Chittorgarh as its Maharana, but he could never do that. Amar Singh, the son of Rana Pratap, ascended throne in 1597. He accepted Mughal sovereignty in 1614 to avoid destruction of Mewar life by prolonging the war. He negotiated peace with Jahangir. Under the treaty, Amar's son Karan Singh attended Mughal court. After the treaty between Amar Singh and Jahangir, there was relative peace in Mewar. However, in 1658, Aurangzeb began holy war against Mewar. But before Aurangzeb could create trouble for Mewar, Shivaji begins war against the Mughals in 1659. After Amar Singh and Karan Singh, Jagat Singh, Raj Singh and Jai Singh ruled Mewar between 1620 to 1698. All of these Maharanas made vast improvements to this palace during their rule. Amar Singh II was coronated in 1698, but he had little problem from Mughals because Aurangzeb had become old and weak by then. Aurangzeb died in 1707. After Amar Singh, Sangram Singh II ruled from 1710 to 1734 and Jagat Singh II ruled from 1734 to 1751. During Jagat Singh's time, Nadir Shah from Persia sacked Delhi in 1739. Nadir Shah returned to Persia, but with him he took a lot of treasure from India, including the peacock throne. Ahmad Shah Durrani from Afghanistan invaded India in 1748, and as he returned to Afghanistan, he left a bloody trail behind him. From 1751 to 1773, three Maharanas reigned in Udaipur: Pratap Singh II, Raj Singh II, and Hari Singh II. All these Maharanas had to pay heavy tributes to Marathas. After satisfying the Marathas, there was very little left for Mewar itself. There was severe drought for about 5 years during this period. Amar Singh II was coronated in 1773 and ruled Mewar until 1778. During his tenure, he invited Sindhi mercenaries to protect Mewar from neighboring states. But these Sindhi mercenaries themselves took over Udaipur and sacked Amar Singh. Amar Singh then had to invite Maratha army to clear the Sindhis and drive them away. Maharana Bhim Singh ruled from 1778 to 1828. During Bhim Singh's tenure, Captain Todd, who endeared Mewari king, provided the Maharana with new ways to improve administration. Also during Bhim Singh's tenure did Mewar sign treaty with British along with other princely states in 1818. During all these years, Udaipur remained the capital of Mewar, and this palace remained the palace of the Maharanas. Maharana Jawan Singh ruled here between 1828 and 1838. Sardar Singh was Maharana between 1838 and 1842. Swarup Singh was Maharana between 1842 and 1861. The age-old practice of Sati was banned in Mewar on August 15 in 1861. Shambhu Singh was Maharana between 1861 to 74. Sajjan Singh was Maharana between 1874 to 1884. Sajjan Singh repaired the Padmini Palace in Chittorgarh in 1882. This picture is that of Maharana Fateh Singh, who ruled from 1884 to 1930, and he is famous for having refused to attend Delhi Darbar when Prince Albert came to India. Maharana Bhupal Singh ruled from 1930 to 1955, but he was the first ruler to join the Indian Union in 1947. When Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel appealed to him. All the princely states of Rajasthan formed the Rajasthan Union of States, which was opened by Nehru. In 1949, the state of Rajasthan was formed. In the year 1969, private purses were deleted. The present occupier of this palace is Arvind Singh Mewar. Arvind Singh Mewar commissioned the Mewar Encyclopedia, from which I have extracted the information that I have given to you here. Look at this ceiling. It shows the beautiful floral painting. This room is known as Krishna Vilas. Here there are many beautiful paintings, photographs, art objects and decorations, all covered with sheets of glass for protection. It is located in the Bhim Vilas Palace. This is Suraj Gokhada, or the Balcony of Sun, where the Suryavamshi sons of the sun god Maharanas of Mewar presented themselves in times of trouble to the people to restore their confidence in this balcony seen here. Let us go inside the balcony. Look at this beautiful wall covered with tiles of beautiful designs. This wall is about 150 years old.